Who was the inventor of the fabulous printing press, and what was the reason for its astonishing success? It was in the German city of Aachen in 1439 that Johann Gutenberg's investors had put their money on the line, but after the failure of his latest money-making plan, they wanted all their money back from that indebted man. They confronted the nervous merchant, sweat glistening on his brow, threatening all the sanctions that the law courts would allow. He should pay them back immediately, or must say when and how. If ever there was a time for a good idea, that time was surely now. Printing, said Gutenberg, to their disbelieving looks, by which I mean the mechanical preparation of a book. His creditors were frowning. Was he as crazy as he seemed? Was there profit in a bookmaking, money-making scheme? I don't mean using blocks of wood to print patterns onto cloth, or inking wooden etchings so the pictures will rub off. I mean making lots of letters out of metal all the same, using them to build a page to print and use again. By using a simple hand mould, we can make standard letters cheaply, and a screw press like we use for wine could print out pages neatly. We could do a copy of the Bible, or some shorter stuff for starters. His investors said, "It better work, or we'll have your guts for garters." In the 2 years it would take a scribe to copy out a Bible, 180 could be made by this mass production rival. Gutenberg went to his grave with his successes unrecorded, and we don't know if his creditors' investments were rewarded. But the printing press gave the written word to ordinary civilians, as the number of books quickly rose from the thousands into millions, drove the Renaissance, the Reformation, and scientific revolution. The technology stayed much the same till the Industrial Revolution. How come it was in Europe that the printing press appears, when in Asia woodblock printing had been known about for years? Block printing books and banknotes was China's big idea, while the first inventors of metal type lived in the Kingdom of Korea. Europeans using feather quills used thicker paper than in China, where they painted characters with a brush onto paper that was finer. While stronger paper was the best that a printing press could get, a more important difference was the use of an alphabet. Developed in ancient times and spread by the Phoenicians, the alphabet was modified by the Romans and the Grecians. It was the ideal tool where different languages were heard, a compact and easy way to write the sounds of any word. It needs thousands of ideograms to write a Chinese book, but for European literature, a few dozen letters is all it took. Movable metal typography was too complex in the East, but in the West, the cost of books could be rapidly decreased. It's Gutenberg who's credited with inventing the printing press, but it's the alphabetical Phoenicians we can thank for its success.